final battle cry. I thought it was a better fit for my final DMA recital. Alexis Shea Carrier studied composition and piano at the University of Montana. This piece was premiered by Dr. Zachary Cooper, who is Assistant Professor of Horn and Coordinator of Music Theory at the University of Montana. In 2016, the final battle cry was selected as an honorable mention in the International Horn Society Composition Competition. In lieu of program notes, the composer provided this poem. A warrior, bedecked in leather armor, alone amidst the cold fog caught in the gloom of a never-ending dusk, stands within a sea of death, his homeland struck down by the plague of war. With no brethren to call upon, he raises his sword as the figures of his enemies form against the disappearing horizon, and continues to stand in courage as he gives the final battle cry. composer and educator whose works have been heard on television and radio across the UK. She is a graduate of both Cardiff University and the Royal College of Music in London. She is a senior lecturer in composition and performance at the University of the West of England, as well as being composer in residence for the Lidbrook Band. Lane describes her music as broadly tonal, with a twist. This piece is also inspired by a poem, Welcome to the Weather, by Jennifer Henderson. The poem reflects the Danish culture of hygge, which has recently become popular in Britain. The poem was originally part of the song cycle Brightest Day, A Cloud, featuring a selection of poems about the weather and travel. I'll read the final verse of the poem. Rainfall in springtime to soften the earth, sunshine at last giving light to the world, warmth that returns with the gift of rebirth, green shoots appearing, leaves not yet unfurled. The promise of life is for everyone. Open your heart to the rain and the sun. Mike, as we are heading across the pond on the next leg of our adventure, I dedicate this piece to you. Cardiff is not known for sunshine, 50 works for orchestra, opera, chorus, chamber ensemble, dance, and multimedia collaborations. Clearfield creates deep, emotive musical languages that build cultural and artistic bridges. About the piece, she says, the work takes its inspiration from the beautiful Roaring Fork in Aspen, Colorado, where she spent many summers as a music festival student. The river changes size and energy from powerful white waters into peaceful streams and deep pools through canyons and into lakes. In River Milos, Midland Odessa Symphony, the Performing Arts Center of Gallup, New Mexico, and the Guadalupe Cultural Arts Center in Texas. Gomez has received numerous composer awards from the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers. She continues to compose chamber music, instrumental and choral collections that are unique in the cultural aspect that only she can provide. Gomez said she composed La Calavera one evening while looking through a stack of Loteria cards. There are 54 Loteria cards, which have pictures of familiar objects such as a woman, a rooster, the devil, watermelon, and the moon. When a card is drawn, the caller has to spontaneously create a rhyme using the name of the object on the card. While thumbing through the Loteria card, she became fixated on card number 42, La Calavera. La Calavera is a skull with crossbones. While working on this mysteriously peculiar piece, she had a strong feeling that the image on the card was guiding her through the composition. She says, "I became so spooked, I wasn't sure if I could continue working on the piece. I was only able to finish it by choosing to believe that the image presented itself to me as a remembrance of a long-lost soul."
Thank you.
She began her performing career at the age of 16 with the Boston Symphony Orchestra and has since performed with the New York City Ballet, Brooklyn Philharmonic, and the Manhattan Chamber Orchestra. She has also solo horn for the Rome Festival Opera. She has recently been focusing on a more improvisatory style in her playing. Path and Pinnacle was originally written for horn, flute, and piano, but the composer was generous enough to transcribe the flute part so I could perform it here today with Wendy on clarinet. continues to pave her own unique path. She's a Grammy-nominated flutist, composer, and entrepreneur. Perhaps most notably, she is the creator, founder, and former flutist of the acclaimed Imani Winds, an ensemble whose performances and original works have redefined wind chamber music with performances that span the globe. Imani Winds' legacy is documented and featured in a dedicated exhibit at the Smithsonian National Museum of African American History and Culture in Washington, D.C. Umoja is the Swahili word for unity and is the first day in seven in the African American celebration of Kwanzaa. The original composition calls for unity through the tradition of call and response and was first meant to be a simple family sing-along song for Kwanzaa. Feel free to come up while I do my thank yous. I don't want to turn this into an Oscar speech, but I do have a number of people I'd like to thank before we play the final piece. I also can't promise I'll get through this without crying. Firstly, thank you to everybody who's watching, whether that's been here, on YouTube, or on Zoom. To all my collaborators today, thank you for being up for learning music that's not by dead white men. To all my friends in the US, both in Philadelphia and in Cincinnati, who have made me feel so welcome and put up with, sometimes even laughed at, my British sense of humor. To Mike's family and friends who have been a constant support, thank you for everything you have done for us over the years. To my friends in the UK, thank you for putting up with the time difference over the past 6 years when we chat, and thank you for making me feel less homesick. All my teachers, but particularly Mr. Gardner, who persuaded me to start my DMA and then invited me to move with him to Philadelphia. To my family, thank you for never making me feel guilty for wanting to pursue my dream so far away from home. Thank you for always being on the other end of the phone and for coming to visit me so many times. And finally, to Mike. You have believed in me and stood by me throughout. You inspire me every day and you always encourage me. I could not have got through this degree without you. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy Umoja.